And still to come, Queen perform magic, and Martin Plaza puts his best foot forward. Now, Howard Jones and No One Is to Blame. Jones tells us how he worked with Phil Collins.
Well, No One Is to Blame, as you know, was on Dream Into Action, right. Just quite a simple version of it. And we'd wanted, at the time, we'd wanted Phil to come down and play drums. I mean, who doesn't? Sort of thing. And he wasn't available to do it. But I met him at Live Aid, and I met him at Top of the Pops. And so we got to know, to talk a bit. And asked him if he'd like to produce No One Is to Blame, and he really loved the song. And so I went down to his place in Surrey where Genesis had a recording studio, and over two weekends, while he was doing the Genesis album, we did it. And Hugh was there as well. And Phil played drums, and we went for a kind of a band feel to the song, you know.
Right.
You know, lots of players on it.
Jones putting the blame on Countdown. The May Countdown magazine's out now with John Taylor going it alone on the cover. And inside, we find out how he does what he does. We visit the set of Dogs in Space to catch up with the latest on Richard Lowenstein and Michael Hutchence. It's your last chance for Countdown's rock video project with Metal as Anything. Hurry, entries close May 9. Tim Finn is starting over with a brand new career in a brand new town. And Martin Plaza savors the sweet success of Concrete and Clay. We continue our trip down memory lane with Madonna. There's pin-up posters of Rick Mayall, Sade, and Martin Plaza. Song words by Prince, The Triffids, The Damned, and many more. All this and more in the May Countdown magazine with David Bowie on the back and John Taylor on the cover. It's out now.
Now, Venetians, put some inspiration into the show.
Comes out of the blue.
like nothing better than a really good joke.
Like the Countdown Awards.
Oh, got you there, Molly. Yeah, oh, here's another joke. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Molly Meldrum.
Molly Meldrum who?
Exactly.
Got you
Molly Meldrum has been sacked for incompetence, and me and Ben Elton have taken over because we're so utterly fantastic.
Yes, we are. And what's more, he's been murdered by the Uncanny X-Men fans.
Yeah, so topical. Let's present the programme. Right, what's next?
It is a brilliant bit of TV.
Great, am I in it?
No, of course not. I've just said it's a brilliant bit of TV.
Oh. Right, well, I'm going to go and sulk in the toilet then.
All right. Come on, Rick. This is a respectable channel. It's Sunday afternoon. Put your trousers on.
Okay. Oh, put my trousers on.
Absolutely. Oh. That's a lot better. Thank you very much.
Sure, we just lost a pop song.
Nice little professional show. Ladies and gentlemen, the National Chartbusters!
Melbourne band Boom Crash Opera climb over the Great Wall from 55 to 35 with their first single.
Watch the trickle, watch it overflow. Gain momentum, swallow simple life. Never want you, never want you round here.
Madonna's number 29 countdown hit is her third single to come off a major film soundtrack. Live to Tell is from Sean Penn's latest flick, At Close Range. This mix of Rock Me Amadeus moves up 14 places for Falco, who keeps a golden bust of Mozart by his bedside. Nothing strange about Falco. Yes, a culture club move away 10 places with the first single from their latest album, From Luxury to Heartache. The big movers on the countdown charts. And still to come, Queen perform magic and Martin Plaza puts his best foot forward. Now, Howard Jones and No One Is to Blame.